separate from the British Army. It was a resounding tactical success.
It is a 7/8 scale replica of the SE-5A that was used in World War I. There, 25 horsepower galloping across the sky here in Abbotsford.
Say the business jet of its day.
Fans, look at him side slipping into the wind there, giving you a bit of a look at the top side.
1970 has a 85 horsepower Continental engine, cruises about 90 miles an
hour. Were built for the Royal Canadian Air Force between 1939 and 1941.
And you know, that just shows you the he's showing off the maneuverability of the software out here right in front of us.
It's got a modern four-cylinder 85 horse.
The mainstay of the Royal Canadian Air Force prior to and during the aircraft that
Canadian team formation. As well, ladies and gentlemen, in the stem of that tee, our flag man today, Master Corporal Stuart Ayers.
And Corporal Antoine Collette and the flag man, Puppy,
are five-time civilian soldiers that choose to serve their country within
their
community.
Please tag us in their photos of today's performance. You can use the hashtag.
I'll direct your attention back up high into the sky, ladies and gentlemen, as our next formation has been built. We call this the three-sack drag. That we call the Candy Cane, deploying a trail of six colorful smoke canisters directly over
us. Sergeant Jenkins is a parachute instructor at the Canadian Army Advanced Warfare Center at CFB Trenton.
There you see, ladies and gentlemen, that Canadian team has evolved.
And that's often referred to as the plan. That was a massive joint military aircrew training program created by the United Kingdom, Canada, Australia, and New Zealand during the Second World War.
Where do you think that's the Bearcat?
Bearcat, yeah.
As long as you've got your health and you meet the man who
you got your health, you can jump into an airplane.
Look at that great big TV.
You think so? I think I did too.
You know where it's a great spot to watch the air show from?
What?
The grandstand. Systems and so much more as they come in from the right.
That's right. The overhead brake. I believe they're going to set up for their landing and then they're going to bring in.
Down in Skagit, Washington, just across the line here. And this is the point. The Sky Raider could have loaded up almost anything they want into the 17. One of the most outstanding torpedo bombers in World War II. This one was actually built just here. But of course, that's for the home packs. And oh, it's up. Look at this.
Here's the Bearcat. A nice, beautiful aileron roll there at center stage. This first torpedo air races was based in England between 1990 and 1997. The possible feature of the Corsair, of course, was its inverted gull wing, which accomplished two purposes. First of all, it permitted the short. Now, the museum's Corsair is an F4U7, and one of the rarest surviving.
Thank you.
folks, Scratch Mitchell and Ace Maker 2. Watch for the new 2 miles per hour. We're going to see the top speed of the T33 right now from the right. Here comes Scratch, this time from our right. Up on the stick and pulls back on the stick in a series of high-performance aileron rolls. On the stick, pitches up and rolls the T33 upside down in the inverted pass. So Roy, I think we need to go to the crowd here and get some input. I want to find out from you folks, who do you think is going to win this race? How many of you think...
American volunteer group, better known as the Flying Tigers. Their P-40B